So you want to record vocals in Cubase?
You trying to scare me off? You trying to tell me?
Let's do it.
So first, we're going to choose our interface. Go to Studio, Studio Setup, and in Audio System, choose your interface from the drop-down menu. So switch. And if you want to go to the control panel, just click on the interface here. This is where you can change the buffer size. In general, a low buffer size is good for recording because of low latency, but it's harder for the computer to handle. And a higher buffer size makes it easier for the computer to process everything, so that's why this is used more for mixing. If your interface allows direct monitoring, you can activate it here. Okay, so now we're going to set up our inputs and outputs. Go to Studio, Audio Connections. And here you'll see some default settings. I have my stereo output here. And then for my inputs, my interface has two inputs and my microphone is plugged into the second one. So I'll have to make sure that that one's activated here as well. I could also create a new mono input for my microphone here. Add bus, mono, mic, and choose my input. But that's not really necessary, as you'll see in a moment. Also important if you're going to record vocals is to save your project in a separate folder, because Cubase is going to save all of your audio files in your project folder. Okay, so next we're going to create an audio track to record on. Right click, add audio track, mono, choose the input. You can also do that later in the routing section here. So this is what I just set up before. I can choose this second one or the new one I created. It's also a good habit to name your track before you start recording, because all of the audio files will get that name. Add track. If I now click the monitoring button, I'll see the input coming in, and you have to make sure that the level is correct. And then just record enable the track here, and you're ready to record. When I'm recording myself, I always make it loop or cycle, so I can record a couple of takes in one go. So hit the record button, and you're off. So that's recorded. Now if I click this button, you'll see that I have several lanes with different takes. Cubase does have a comping function, but I prefer just cutting and pasting to different tracks. If you do want to use comping, I'll quickly show you how. So this hand is the comp tool. You can use it to select the best parts of your takes, like this. And to listen to the alternative takes, just click them. The highlighted ones are the ones playing. You can also edit the cut points with this handle. But I like even more control, so that's why I actually don't use this myself. But if you're happy with the result here, you can clean it up by selecting the audio. Then go to Audio, Advanced, Delete Overlaps.
So I hope this helped. If it did, please like the video and also subscribe and have fun making music.